binary search. Where we are going to apply the binary search? In real life, we are applying this in our day-to-day life. Where exactly? You can say a dictionary. In dictionary, we search for a word. So how we search for a word? Suppose I'm going to search for a meaning of this value, middle. So how I will do? First, we skip the alphabets before M. That is M, L. L, after L, M. Then after N also, after M also we will do, that is N. So up to L we skip. Then after N also, from N also we will do. Directly we go to the letter starting with M. Then within that M, we go straight to the I. We don't go for A, M, A, M, B, M, C. We directly go to the word start with M and I. And within MI, we search for D. Likewise, we keep on concentrating or narrow downing our search. So this is how we do our, we find our middle element. That is the value, the meaning for a particular value which we are searching in our dictionary. So that is what binary search. Now we'll see this algorithm later. Here what we are going to do, first I will explain with an example and then I will come back to this algorithm. Here let us take an array of 9 elements. So these are all nothing but index 0 to 8 index. Now what we have to do is we have to find the middle value. So how we will find the middle value? By adding the first value and the last value. So first value is 0 and last index is 8 by adding first index and last index. So 0 plus 8, it is 8 divided by 2. That is what our middle. So what you have to do, find the middle element in the list by the formula middle equal to first plus last by 2. That's what we are doing. So 4 is the value, 4 is the index and the value we present is 39. Now the search element, the value which we are going to search is 20. We are going to check whether it is present in the upper half or lower half. Upper half or lower half. Since our elements are in an array, the binary search can be applied only for a sorted element. This is the first rule. So as per that rule, the list will be in a sorted element. So when we are going to search for 20, we check whether the middle value is greater than or smaller than the search value. Definitely 20 will be in the left portion of this array. And here, this cannot be present here because of this ordered manner, sorting manner. So we are going to leave all these values. Our concentration is only in this. We can find our element only here. Now, so in this first step, we found the middle value and we are going to restrict our search only in the first portion. So here, now we take only 10, 20, 25, 30 as our sublist. So we are creating a sublist. So here what we have to do is, now this is the first index, but what about the last index? Last index is 8, but after finding the middle, since we are restricting our search only in this, we have to modify the last index. So now the last index is nothing but middle minus 1. So here, if you see that, if the search element is, now it is 20, is less than middle, 39. So it is less than, the middle value is less than the search element. Sorry, middle element is greater and the search element is less than the middle element. So repeat the step 2, 3, 4, 5. What is step 2? Find the middle element again. Then compare the search element with the middle element. Now you have to compare it. If both are same, then display the element is 4. If the middle element is equal to 20, then we got the element. Or else, then check whether the search element is greater than or smaller than the middle element. This is what we have to do repeatedly. So now 2, 3, 4, 5 are the left sublist of the middle element. So now the last element becomes middle minus 1. Now, here we check, this is the middle element initially. We check whether 20 is equal to 39. No, Then we check whether it is greater than or smaller than. Definitely, middle is greater, which means our element search to be searched is smaller. So our restriction is within this sublist. So now we take only those things. So here last element is 3, because according to the algorithm, last element becomes middle minus 1, which is nothing but 3. So this is the first element and 3 is the last element. So now within this we have to find the middle, which is nothing but 0 plus 3, that is first plus last divided by 2. So 0 plus 3 divided by 2, which is equal to 1. So here last element is 3. Now we'll see the next slide. So here 0 plus 3 divided by 2, it is 1. So we have to take the integer portion. We leave the fractional part. So now first is 0 and last is 3. Here, this is the element. Now I have taken only the first 4. Within that, we have found the middle value according to this formula. Now this is the middle. Now we check the value whether it is equal to the value which is present in the middle is equal to the value which we are searching. So both are equal because we are searching only for 20. So at the second search itself, the second step itself, we have found the match and the algorithm ends because we have found the element. Now let us take another example. It's the same array, but what we are going to search is 50. So now we have to find the middle value. Again, taking the whole array. Again, the middle value is 4 and 39. Now, when we check 39, definitely it is smaller than the search element. So now, where we have to search? After the middle. So now, we have to modify the first index. The first and last. Initially, it is 0 and 8. Now, you have to modify the first because it is greater. It will be present after the middle. So now middle plus 1, according to the algorithm, if the search element is greater than the middle, repeat the steps 2, 3, 4, 5 for the right sublist of the middle element. So now it becomes middle plus 1 becomes the first element. So here now 5. 5 is the first element. So with 5, so this is the sublist 40, 43, 50, 58. In this, the first is 5 and last is 8. So that is what, 5 and 8. Now when you add these two and divide it by 2, you will get the middle value of this sublist, which is nothing but 6. So here go to 6 and check whether it is equal to 50, because the 50 is the search element. It is not. So no match is found. Now we have to split the value again. Now we know that 50 is above the middle value. So our search is here. So we leave these two values. Now again, according to our rule, it becomes middle plus 1. So 7. This is the first value and this is the last value. So 7 plus 8 by 2, we get 7. So 7 is the middle value now. Now we are checking whether the value in the middle is equal to our search value, which is 50. Yes. Now it returns the index. So it says that the value which you are searching is present and it is present at the 7th index. So stop the algorithm. Now, so read the element to be searched, whether it is 20 or 50. That is what we have done. So read the element, first create an array, and the array must be in a sorted order. This is the condition. Now read the element to be searched. Now find the middle element in the list by the formula first plus last by 2. Then compare the search element with the middle element. Always you compare the search element with the middle value only. So if it is present in the middle value, then till it becomes smaller and smaller and smaller and it reaches the correct middle value, we keep on iterating. So if both are same, if the value in the middle is equal to the search element, then we say element is found and stop. If both are not matched, then check whether the search element is greater than or smaller than the middle element. If search element is less than middle, then repeat these steps for the left sublist. Now you will be creating the left sublist. You leave the all the rightmost element of the middle. And middle minus 1 becomes the last element. Anyway, if search element is greater than middle, repeat step 2, 3, 4 and 5 for the right sublist of the middle element. And middle plus 1 becomes the first element of the left sublist. And repeat above process Till we find the search element, until subdisk contains only one element. If that element is also doesn't match, then display element not found. There are cases where the element may not be present in the array also. In which condition you will iterate the whole thing and then you skip and you say that element is not found. So this is the binary search algorithm. Now, how to implement it in a programmingly. Now we can see binary search. Here you pass the value. You declare the local variable first, last, middle. Initially first is 0 and last is nothing but length minus 1. What is the length? That minus 1. Because since we start from 0. So we are checking whether first is less than. Yes, only this condition only the whole thing valid. If the sometimes it may not, the first may become more than the last, in which case the element is not present. Okay, so keeping on dividing by middle, it may reaches the last element. So in which case the element is not present. So till the first element is less than the last element, you keep on doing. So find the middle and then you keep on checking whether the middle is equal to value. If it is, then you say it is and you are returning. So that itself return and you break the while loop. Or else you check whether the middle value is greater than the value. Now in that case, modify the last. Else you modify the, if the middle value is greater, lesser than the value, then you modify the first and make it a check in the right surplus by modifying the value accordingly.